Actually, we have body blocking going on. Game Chest taking some damage. Nice gravity lap's going down the ETC. Meadow getting really low. He does end up going down. First blood going to Blaze, but it does damage to the core based off of how many forts you can currently control. But actually, we have a fight going down. Aragi getting pretty low. Gets flipped. He's going to end up going down. Bay is down. That's going to be 4 kills to nothing in favor of Blaze. Still a 4v4 fight. Yuzh is going for the cat. Banelings come in. Moonfire's going to be able to disengage it as well. And they are on full retreat. Game Chest going for the cat. Meadow is here to zone out as well. Game Chest trying to cap again, and it looks like they will finally end up giving it up to Team Blank. They're aggressively defending the spot up here from Shot sends in the Banelings. The flank comes in from ETC. He's going to get blown up. Gravity Lapse goes down. There's the Phoenix as well. Here comes the Precision Strike and Mosh Pit on top of 4 people. A lot of damage going down on the end of Blaze. ETC is going to fall, but they're going to lose Uther as well, and the rest of them are going to have to back out.
Alphacopter is also pretty low, but trying to come back in. They still want to be able to push people off. They want both of these altars. They know that Kael'thas already is picking one up, and they are going to be able to get Zagara. Lightning Breath going to try to zone out Game Chest and Aragi, but they will be able to get another takedown on top of Diablo. Game Chest needs to be able to get into this zone. Does not do so. 4 people down.
22 HP, and they might catch no battle position here. The follow-up stun's perfect. Oh, what a great maw from Shot, able to save them. And the Precision Strike comes out on top of it. Dwarf Toss at last second from Battery. Going to keep them alive. They try to get the slow on the Rafa. Copter and Yuzh, but not able to do that. So what was a really bad situation there. Love how aggressive Blaze is being here. They're going to be pushing with the Siege camp here as we do see Meadow and Game Chase going for the flank. Nova's going to be the first to fall in this fight, though. Meadow dashes through, does end up getting Shrink right there. That's a lot of damage going down on the Divine Storm use. And that's going to be the death of Meadow as well, and that's going to be probably the death of this fort following. And at the same time, we have the tunnels that are opening up, and that's going to allow them to teleport from their base to the middle of the map.
Yeah, this is the more standard Nova build that we see before. You mentioned the anti-armor shells and then also Lethal Decoy and Double Fake. Here comes the Lightning Breath on Game's Chest and Biceps, but Tranquility keeping everyone so alive. They are close. Icebox has to go down, and they're in the mosh pit. Diablo falls. There is the Divine Storm, too, and ETC is going to go down, too. So far, a 2 for 2 on each side. Biceps so incredibly low. Everyone so low. 4 down now. Only Shot remaining, and it will be a team wipe. On the side of Blank, 2 versus 31 in terms of the core health. Level 20 Storm Talents picked up too. We have Hellstorm upgrade to Lightning Breath. There goes the Divine Storm as well, used right in there. Lightning Breath's gonna come out from the backside on everybody. And there is a Mosh Pit too, so both tanks just trying to catch everybody out. Rainer will be the first, second to fall. Nova is down too.
Shot last fort fall, GG.
There we go.
There we go. Yep, they got that last fort. They just fought on top of it. We're able to secure it there. And then you don't have to fully have it revived for the shots to start firing. So the moment they cap that, he is top tier. Cool. We have a gank coming down the Meadow in the top lane. He gets leaped on by Battery. The stun does go out. Claudius with the follow-up route, and that's going to be first blood going over to Blaze. Claudius and Battery rotating up for the gank. He does end up coming forward, hits the chain lightning, no root follow up. It looks like they're just going to go for a push, but at the same time, a gank in the bottom lane, going to catch out Rainer there. That's going to be Blank securing their first kill as well.
That was an awesome gravity lapse by Biceps, and that's going to mean they get their first kill as well as those giants.
A much better handling of the map than we saw the first time versus Blaze there, and a nice double stun coming out on the Rogi and Shot. They're going to get taken down very, very quickly there, and a turnaround kill. Rafflecopter was the one getting very low there, and a Rogi should end up going down. No, a nice dash away, but the chain lightning potentially could be enough to bounce to him. He does throw it out. It does not connect in time. If that was a few seconds earlier, it would have been enough, but that last second heal, of course, able to top him off. Kills 4-1 in favor of Team Blaze right now. Blank trying to take their own giants. Looks like an invasion might end up coming, though. And remember, this is a 5v4. Zagara coming from the fake. And a nice round on Meadow. He gets hit by the 7-sided strikes, getting very low. Spins try to keep himself alive, but he does go down. There is the Sundry coming out from Thrall. They root Aragi. He heals himself up. The shield from Game Chest as well, trying to keep him topped up. They're both getting so low. Game Chest is going to fall. Aragi is going to be able to get away. It's going to be a 2-for-nothing exchange. And the giants go over to Team Blaze. We're going to be doing a lot more damage. Water Elemental goes over the wall there. Shot revealing where his team are. They're coming in now. The stun goes up. A nice 7-side strike. Ooh, but it does mosh pit. It misses for a second. Get the monk there at the last second, but Aragi got interrupted by the piercing round from Rafflecopter, and the rest of the team is coming in here. Battery at half HP. Jason coming up from above. The stun goes out on the Meadow. The Sun Ring comes out. Jaina's going to fall. Looks like Meadow's going to go down right after him. A 2-for-nothing exchange. Jason looking for the chase on Aragi. Does not end up securing that kill. Yep, it's taken very, very low. It's definitely going to go down here as Jason, of course, with the Zagara, makes it so much easier to push into these things with Uther dead for 17 seconds. That is going to be 2 keeps down, 12 minutes into the game. Blaze showing you why they're contenders to win this tournament. They are playing phenomenally well.
Two Keep's already down, so there's going to be a lot of minion pressure on the core as well to help soak up some of those shots. They do need to make sure that they're spreading out. They are sieging up against the chain bomb, and you see Jason moving out with that chain bomb to ensure that Divine Shield goes down on top of Jaina. Phoenix trying desperately to zone everyone away. Araragi in there looking for the perfect mosh pit, but of course has to be careful because up against that Rainer, it gets hit out immediately into the seven-sided strike. Araragi so close to being taken out, he will fall. Devouring Maw goes in, doesn't grab anybody. GG's already being called, and Blaze, after two series not being able to defeat Blank, finally does so to win this qualifier.
I'm sprinting.
You ready?
Oh, nice.
Bomb.
Oh, oh no, we bomb! We just wrecked that kid!